Hello everybody, welcome back again to Mr. Wisp 254. So in today's lesson, I want us to go through how you can be able to use an address list, how you can be able to make an address list, and I also want to show you how you can be able to generate, auto-generate an address list from any particular website. So the first step, you need to come to IP Firewall. Then you need to come to address list. I have a few that I've already populated here. I'm going to show you how I came up with this. So let's add a new one. So we are going to add maybe 172.16.20.0/24. No, that's supposed to be the name. Maybe we can name this as a drop for expired accounts. That's going to be the name. So maybe your expired accounts, the expired accounts get an IP of 172.16.0. Let's say .10.0/24. Apply that. Okay. Maybe we can also add something else, like let's say 172.17.0.0/24. Nope, that's supposed to be the name. I don't know why I keep forgetting. Let's use the same name. Drop for expired accounts, and the address should be 172.17.0.0/24. Apply that. Okay. So we have two different subnet for IPs here, and let's say we want to do a particular action to them. So probably what you want to do is you want to come to filter rules, add, and maybe you come to advance, and the source address, you pick drop for expired accounts. Action, this is going to be drop, then apply that, and okay. So what this rule does basically is anybody who has either an IP from these two blocks, their connection is going to be dropped and they are not going to have any internet connection. So basically that is how you create an address list locally for whatever reasons that you want to do. And you can use this address list also for NAT. You can use it for mangle rules as well. So another thing that I also want to show you is how you can be able to auto-generate an address list for, let's say, WhatsApp, YouTube, Yahoo, Gmail, whatever website that you want to generate an address list for. So what you need to do, you need to come to row, add, then come to the advanced tab, and let's say you want to have an address list for, say, Yahoo. So you're just going to come to the content and type yahoo.com, and the action, this is going to be add to destination address list, and the name, let's give this name Yahoo. Apply. Okay. So if you come to your address list, you're going to see that Yahoo, all addresses associated with yahoo.com should be able to auto-populate here. So, and for that to happen, you also need to be using Yahoo so that all those addresses are captured here. So the more you keep using a particular website, the more you get all the addresses that are associated to it. So let's just come to our browser, and maybe let's do yahoo.com, enter. So as it does that, if you come back to your MikroTik, you should be able to see that the addresses are now being populated. So, and that's the same thing that I've also done for WhatsApp. That's the same thing that I've also done for YouTube as well. So if you come to Raw, let me see, this is Yahoo. Or the previous one, this is WhatsApp. And the other one, this is YouTube. I've also realized that for YouTube and WhatsApp, it's taking a bit of time for them to auto-populate. But the more your clients or anybody who is connected to that network uses Yahoo, the more that person uses YouTube, the more that person uses WhatsApp, the more the address list is going to be populated. You can also do the same for, let's say, Facebook. So we come to General, Advanced, Content, let's say, Facebook.com. The action, this is going to be add to destination address list, and the address list, this is going to be Facebook. The address list name. So apply that. Okay. So if you come to your address list, Facebook should also start populating here if and when people start using Facebook. So let me just try and open Facebook. So as it's loading, let's go back to our MikroTik. So you can see Facebook has already also started being populated, and you can see we already have three IPs captured. So with this address list, you can do whatever thing that you want. Maybe you can come to Firewall, add, maybe the General tab, Advanced tab. Let's say you want to maybe say block Facebook or WhatsApp, whatever you want to do. Maybe let's try with the Yahoo action drop. Okay, so that means that all traffic to Yahoo is going to be dropped. So we can also come back to our browser and let's try and see if yahoo.com is going to open up. Oops, sorry, I think I picked the wrong address list. Let's just confirm. Yeah, I think I picked YouTube instead of Yahoo. So let's pick Yahoo. Okay, so let's go back to our browser. Let's try and refresh this. So you see, it will just keep on refreshing and nothing is going to happen. Let's try and open a new tab, yahoo.com. It's not going to open that. So guys, that's how you're able to generate an address list. It's that simple. And from the address list that you've generated, you can do tons and tons of stuff with the address list that you've generated, from the filter rules to NAT to mangle rules and every other thing. You are able to accomplish that from the address list that you've created. So thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more videos like this, and please remember to subscribe and share this channel with your friends as well. Bye bye.